Hello guys, my name is Jeroen, and as a deep learning enthusiast, I've been experimenting with the NVIDIA-powered GPU servers on Oracle Cloud, so let me share my experiences of that with you. The idea behind these servers is basically raw performance, and that sounded great to me because I know how frustrating it is when you have to wait for your experiments to complete, and how lack of performance sometimes makes it impossible to even reach your goal. I had three questions I wanted answers for. First of all, how does it perform? That makes sense. Secondly, how easy is it to use? How practical is it? And thirdly, how does one actually pay for such a cloud service? And can it compete with installing my local GPU hardware? So let me show you what I found out. And in this example, we're going to apply the style of one image, in this case the style of Van Gogh's Starry Night, to another image, the content image, in this case the Wonders of the World. And it doesn't really matter how style transfer works in this case. The point here is that it's a process that demands a lot of processing power, so it can probably benefit from a bit of GPU acceleration. Let's start with the most important point. How was the performance? Here you see the style transfer process being run. On the left side you see my own hardware. It has a fairly simple i5 processor at 2.5 GHz. It does not have any GPU acceleration, by the way. And on the right hand side we see the GPU cloud instance. This particular instance has two NVIDIA Pascal GPUs, but there are actually various configurations that you can choose from, up until 8 NVIDIA Volta GPUs. Slowly but surely we see the painting taking shape, at least on the GPU instance. I can already see some familiar shapes. I can see the Colosseum, Machu Picchu, the Taj Mahal. And clearly my laptop is no match at all. It's still far behind and you cannot really recognize anything on that side yet. And if we wait a little bit longer, on the GPU instance, we can now also see the style of Van Gogh coming into play. You see those typical strokes and the fairly dark colors from that Starry Night painting. I don't think he ever visited any of these world wonders, but imagine if he had been there, this is how he might have painted what he saw. In my opinion, this is one very impressive application of deep learning. I'm no art expert, but the end result looks like real paintings to me. Style transfer really gives the effect of something being created by a human being. Anyway, after about 1.5 minutes, the GPU instance has completed the process. So let's see how long it takes my poor laptop to finish. I'll do a fast forward in time. And this actually takes over 7 hours. So for this test case and these configurations, we get a performance increase of a factor 280. Now, obviously, this is not an official comparison, but it does give you an impression. It just shows how essential GPU acceleration is for deep learning. So now let's see how this thing works. Here you see my GPU instance already up and running. I've set everything up. And basically it's just a machine that we access through SSH using this IP address here. But of course a very powerful machine. Now by default this server is pretty empty. It just has the operating system and very little else. So what you could do is install all of the dependencies yourself. So what am I talking about then? Well, for example, the GPU accelerated TensorFlow libraries, the CUDA libraries, and these basically give you access to that GPU hardware, and any other dependencies. But if you're into deep learning, you know that it can be quite tricky to get all the software with the exact right versions as well installed. So it's very good to know that there is a second option, and this is the option I chose for my example, and it's called the NVIDIA GPU Cloud. This is not another cloud environment we're going to use. All it means is that we will download the Docker images from NVIDIA to the Oracle infrastructure. And these Docker images are self-contained software stacks, including drivers, including libraries, and any software that may be required. So let me show you a few screenshots of the Docker registry. Apart from the deep learning category, we also see things such as high performance computing and visualization, because also in those fields, GPU acceleration is a big thing. But we are interested in the deep learning section, of course, and we see that there are various pre-built Docker images available. In our case, we will pull the TensorFlow image. And I think this is a pretty cool mechanism because I basically get a guarantee that the software stack just works together and performs together, of course. So let's do this. So we're going to log into the server using this address. In red, I enter the NVIDIA API key, and that's a key you can get at the NVIDIA website. This basically authenticates you against the NVIDIA Docker registry. So at this point, our server is pretty much still empty. but we're ready to download the NVIDIA TensorFlow Docker image. And here's the syntax to do that. The first download and build of your container will take a few minutes, so again, I'll just fast forward. Now, as a minimum example, let me just show you Python, import TensorFlow, and show you that GPU acceleration is enabled. Actually, there was a typo here, and this is the right syntax. And indeed, we see that GPU is enabled. Now, at this point, I ran the style transfer test that you saw in the beginning of the video, but I guess many of you will just want to run your own experiments, your own processes. And the great thing is that everything is already set up now. So far so good, but I'm still left with the question of how this compares with installing own GPU hardware and locally. So let's come back to this topic of hardware, and here we see the shapes that you can choose from. I would actually ask you to have a look at this URL instead, because here you also see up-to-date price information. So the way it works is that you consume your cloud credits for every hour that you use these instances. And that's of course very different from a one-time big investment for local hardware. So with cloud, you get access to an enormous amount of GPU acceleration, probably often not feasible to try to create locally yourself. Just have a look here at these 8 NVIDIA Volta GPUs. That's quite a beast. And the nice thing, of course, about this cloud approach is that you can use those deep learning environments. You can run your processes fast, get an end result, and then stop using them. And this is where you do that, basically by terminating an instance. Then your cloud credits also stop consuming. The trick here is to keep your disk, because that's of course where your work is, and you can restart then at any time reusing that disk. If you want to get your hands on your own free GPU trial, check out my article here below on PointDrive with all the steps to take. There's also some tricky parts actually to set up the environment, so that cost me a few hours. Hopefully you don't have to go through the same thing. I must say I'm very happy with the results of the experiment. It was very easy to use these NVIDIA Docker containers to download them, to install the test case and to run it. The performance was very good, even though it didn't use the top shape. Now, in my opinion, it makes a lot of sense to use cloud to run these kind of peak workloads and then to just turn the environment off when you don't need it. So that's it for now. I hope this was useful for you. Please let me know if you have any questions or comments, and see you in the next video. Bye!